Hello students, I hope all of you are ready with your English textbook. Please open page 33. Students, yesterday we discussed about the young seagull being rebuked and reprimanded by his family members for not mustering up the courage to fly. Yes, and he was left all alone on the ledge to starve. Today, let us see what happens. The seagull was watching his parents training his brothers and sisters to fly, the art of flying. They were teaching him the art of flying and how to skim on the sea and dive for fish. And you know, they were cackling with pride when his brother caught the first fish, that is a silvery fish that is called a herring, and devoured it. And they just go on to the cliff. They were walking on the cliff opposite to him and taunting him like anything for his lack of courage and confidence. Now here, this seagull was really filled with hunger as almost 24 hours has passed off, and he was wanting to grab the attention of his family members. What he does is he starts pretending as if he's about to sleep. But no one notices him. His brothers and sisters were dozing off, and his father was busy preening his feathers. Preening means here to clean his feathers, was busy preening his feathers. But his mother notices him now and then. She was also biting into a piece of fish and scraping her beak on the rock. And this really maddened him, as he liked that way of piercing the fish and eating the piece of flesh and then wetting. I mean, here wetting means not wetting with any liquid or anything, just scraping the beak on the rock. Yes, he was extremely hungry and giving out pathetic screams for food. And his mother responds derisively. Here derisively means actually to ridicule. She was calling him like he was so worthless that he is unable to fly, or not even trying to fly, as it was a basic skill for a bird to fly. Later, to his great astonishment, he finds that his mother was coming towards him with a piece of a fish in her beak. His joy knew no bounds, as it was going to satiate his hunger. But he was in for a rude shock as his mother stops just before him with the fish dangling in her mouth. Now, we already know he was without food for almost 24 hours and his hunger pangs were increasing. And now what he does, he has to overcome his fear if he wants the food. So what he does, he has no other choice left and he leaps towards the fish in his mother's beak. And you know what happens? He realizes that he was flying in the sky. He had to take that plunge to catch the fish in his mother's beak. He gives out a loud scream and there is an enormous terror like gripping within him. Why is it so? Because he was hesitating to fly, isn't it? Now he just took a plunge, and that plunge he took only just as he was unable to control his hunger. And now he was flying in the sky. He realizes that he was not going down, but he was flying like any other bird would fly. And he could feel the wind gushing on his face. And his family members all surround him and start praising him and congratulating him for taking that plunge, or to he overcoming his fear to fly. And they all go ahead of him onto the plain landing of the sea, or the plain flooring of the sea. And he also follows them. But again, a fear starts within him as soon as he lands on the flooring of the sea, as he feels that he was going to sink. But actually, he doesn't sink. He was floating on the sea. And his family members, that is his parents and siblings, they come to him as with a dog fish and feed him over his success of his first flight. So Students, what did you learn at the end of today's lesson, His First Flight by Liamao Flaherty? You saw that the young seagull could conquer his fear. Yes, he could conquer his fear of flying. And actually, what were the two major factors that were obstructing him to fly? That was his self-belief and self-confidence. He was able to do it finally. Yes, with whose support? With the support of his family members and especially his mother. You know, like she throws a bait on him to catch the fish. Even she was feeling bad that he was hungry for almost 24 hours. So she wants to just teach him her lesson and know that you can conquer fear. Yes, students, we being human beings, have fear as an integral part. We need to conquer it. If we conquer fear, fear won't conquer us. If we don't, you can understand what I mean. So, if you want to go on a journey of 1,000 steps, you need to take that single step. So, take that single step with great confidence and venture further, and there will be no turning back. It will be only you doing wonders. Thank you.